1861, the crossroads of conflict for a divided Union converge in Charleston, South Carolina. As the hour of war approached, 127 men at Sumter were about to face over 6,000 Confederates stationed at 10 batteries and two forts surrounding Sumter. Lieutenant George S. James, a retired Army officer at Fort Johnson, was ordered to prepare his guns to fire the first shot.
It was a very momentous event. Who would fire the first shot? And James looked at Roger Pryor and gave him the option of firing the first shot.
However, Colonel Roger Pryor, a leading fire eater and secessionist, declined. He confessed he couldn't fire the first gun of the war.
So James then had his second in command, a Lieutenant Farley, prepare one of his mortars for action. And when he looked at his watch, it was 4:30. Lieutenant Farley yanked the lanyard, fired the first round. It was a splendid shot. It burned for nearly 13 seconds, and moments later, the Virginian Edmund Ruffin yanked the lanyard that fired the first shot from Morris Island that struck Fort Sumter. And so commenced somewhat of a debate of who really fired the first shot.